Good afternoon, and welcome to the final episode in this series of Cadzo Conversations. This is the 24th week of Cadzo Conversations, and what started as a simple midweek reflection has exceeded all of our expectations. When we started doing this, we weren't in church. We needed another way to connect to the members of our congregation here in Cadzo, and rather than simply have a midweek reflection by the minister or another midweek sermon delivered by one of our worship leaders, we felt that it was important to hear the voices of all the people in Cadzo. We could not have expected what a success Cadzo Conversations has turned out to be. We have a wide and varied audience, not just from our own congregation, but from across the world. In fact, the 14 different contributors that we've had to this process have been viewed by over 6,900 times, and that is just a fantastic achievement. But why has it worked so well? Probably because the idea itself is very simple. We ask people in the church to talk about their faith, to discuss what influences there have been in their lives and where God has taken them. And to date, we have received some wonderful testimonies, many of them from people you would not normally hear talk about such matters. And I think that this has been key to its successes. Normally, when you see churches communicate, it is ministers or other hygienists that are doing the talking. But over the past 15 months, we have not had the opportunity to sit down and to talk to our friends or to the people we sit beside. We have not heard the familiar voices for so long, so to sit and listen to Carolyn tell us all about her experiences working with children, to Eddie and Alex talking about the importance of music, Moira sharing the joys of her garden, Patricia on her experience as an elder, and of course, Hammy's wonderful pictures of Africa, to highlight just a few. We think this is more meaningful to us than simply listening to just another sermon. But I think Cadzo Conversations has been so much more than that. It has been a link to us, to the outside world, to let people on Facebook and YouTube who might not normally have viewed a video from a little church in Hamilton, to see what the Christian witness here in Scotland is at this minute in time, to listen to what people are trying to say and how important, particularly over the past 15 months, faith has been to people in giving them the strength to work through this terrible disease that we have had. And I feel it is really important that we now start to grab onto that faith and start to restore our lives to some form of normalcy. Restrictions are easing. Rules are changing. Hopefully soon we will only have to sit 1 metre apart in the church. We might not have to wear face masks, but even if we do, we should hopefully soon be allowed to sing. And we'll start to see Cadzo Parish Church and all the other churches around the world get back to being places full of joy, of worship of the Lord, and of voices raised in praise. But there's one thing that we need back more than anything else, and that is our people. Not just the people who faithfully attended each week, but hopefully others who have seen what we do here at Cadzo or what the Church of Scotland is doing, and who feel that after such a difficult time, they have place in their hearts for faith in God who has brought us through these times. So here, in this last of our Cadzo Conversation episodes for the time being, I have a challenge for you. But before I say what it is, please do not think that casual conversations are going to stop. We're just taking a short break for the summer. We will be back in August, and we have some great new fresh ideas to try and bring more people's voices to the screen. Hopefully you saw last week Beth and Katie talking about their experiences in the church, being interviewed by Alex, and we expect to have more of that type of chat going on. We're also going to involve some ministers from our churches around us, people who are friendly, who we work with closely. But most of all, we want to hear from you. And my challenge to you is this. Please don't be afraid any longer to come to church. Church is a safe place. It's a place where your friends are, where people have been coming successfully since we opened our doors back up in late March. So please take the big step. I know you may be scared, but you have nothing to fear from church. And you have nothing to fear also from being videoed as we have one of our conversations. So please share the experience that you have had. Come back and sit with your neighbours and have a proper casual conversation in the pews of our church on a Sunday morning. Let us pray. Dear Lord, our Heavenly Father, we thank you for all of the great gifts that you have given to us. We thank you for bringing us through this dreadful pandemic, seeing us safe through to this side so that we can then get on with our lives. But doing so in the memory of the people that we have lost. Give us the strength to share with each other the love of God. Give us the strength to help each other through continuing difficult times. Give us the strength to come back into your presence and your love. Lord, we thank you so much for all who have given their time and their efforts to bring us these little nuggets of joy throughout the pandemic. Thank you for the gifts that you gave to them. Thank you for the gifts that you have given to us. These things we ask in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.